Welcome to r/neighborsfromhell. In this subreddit, people share stories about their crazy neighbors. Before we start, if you are new to my channel, please don't forget to click subscribe to join our friendly community. And now, without wasting any more time, let's dive right in. What is your best idiot neighbor story? Posted by The Fashy. My dad had a neighbor when he was young that played his radio loudly all day, even when he was not home or was gone on vacation. Every time he left the house and his radio was still on, my dad would go and trip the circuit breaker to his condo. One day he sees my dad, who was an electrical engineer, and asked him why his breaker kept tripping. Was it faulty wiring? No, my dad explained. The loud radio was probably just putting too much strain on the circuit when left on all the time. My dad suggested he should try turning it down or off when he was not home and see if that fixed it. So the man tried it, and surprise, surprise, the circuit breaker stopped tripping. He was very thankful to my dad for helping him with that annoying electrical issue. I gotta admit, that's a very clever way of dealing with that situation, because I would have probably freaked out if I had an idiot neighbor like that. Posted by Confused Monkey. When I was a kid, we had this guy living next door who seemed like a nice guy. This is the mid-90s and he had a neon business, so he was doing pretty well for himself. Then he got together with a crackhead and his house slowly started going to crap. Literally. At one point his septic system went up, and since they were smoking every dime he made, he decided that he was just going to make a cesspit. We live on the East Coast, in the mid-Atlantic, it gets hot and humid come July. Thanks to this guy, our entire neighborhood smelled like a spotted pot at Midsummer Festival for about 3 months. Fast forward to January, nice and snowy, we come home to our house being broken into. Computer is gone, TV is gone, bunch of movies and mats are gone. Cops show up and they start dusting and looking around. They go outside, and lo and behold, there are tracks going from our side door back to the neighbor's house. Of course, they deny everything and are at least smart enough not to keep the stuff around after we got home. They were not smart enough to use different names, they pawned everything though. Needless to say, we had new neighbors within a few months of this incident. Next one, posted by TGIC1. I live on a 50 plus acre New England farm. About 2/3 of it is wooded. After I had been here for about a year, I was walking the boundary stone wall about 10 feet on my side of the land. Or is that 10 inches? I'm not sure. Anyway, from a neighbor's yard, I hear a bellowing voice.
You better not be on my land.
I replied, I'm not, I'm on my own land. He yells back from somewhere in the trees on his side.
Just so you know, never step foot on my land.
Me? Okay, we've got a deal, and you stay off mine, okay? I hear a grunt. Then I ask, by the way, is this your deer hunting tree stand on my side of the wall? At which point he exploded,
that stand has been there for 10 years.
Next story was posted by The Real Bobby C. I had a neighbor with a drag racing car. At the time, we did not have AC. Like clockwork, at dinner time, he would start the car and revved it so loud my windows rattled. If we had any windows open, because it was summer, we would not be able to have dinner conversation. One day, I'd had enough. I walked to the fence and got his attention and politely asked if he could maybe not rev the car at dinner time. I said I was cool with it otherwise. His answer was,
F you.
F me? Huh, okay. I went inside and called the police and filed a noise complaint. They came out, heard it live, and wrote him up. He fought it in court, so I had to go. Judge asked me what happened, I told the story above, she asked him and his wife if it was true, they said yes, boom, $1,000 fine. Judge told me to call the police if it continued. To be clear, I was not wasting 911 time, I was calling the non-emergency ordinance enforcement number. All dumbass had to do was avoid 1 hour a day and we would have been fine. I never called again because he did not rev during dinner. One day, his common-law wife gets in my face about calling again. I told her I didn't, but she would not believe me. He got hit with a second $1,000 fine. Turns out it was the neighbor two houses away who was a migraine sufferer and had similarly tried the neighborly approach first. I don't know how you feel about that story, but honestly, I applaud these people for their patience. If someone would rev their freaking car during dinner time, I could not be as calm as this guy. Next one was posted by Napalm Anal Emission. Couple that lives across the hall from me fights often and loudly. One night, the girl found something on the guy's phone that she found objectionable. Either porn or evidence of cheating, either way, she was yelling a lot about skanks and SLUTS, so she throws his phone off the second floor balcony onto the concrete walkway below where it shatters. Guy then goes back inside, grabs her phone and does the same. Moral of the story is, an iPhone for an iPhone makes the whole world entertaining for the neighbors. Follow up to that story posted by the Winter Lily, this reminds me of my old neighbor. Woman in her late 20s, raising two kids on her own. They are always throwing tantrums and she's always screaming at them loud enough for everyone in the building to hear. My partner was on night shifts and heard her screaming and crying at her boyfriend about cheating on her. 2 weeks later, same thing but in the middle of the afternoon. It happens a few other times. The day we moved, she was taking him and her kids to Tim Hortons. I don't really understand how people have the patience and will to continue with people they have to scream and cry and beg for. Well, to be honest, isn't that always part of a relationship? I mean, I could be wrong here, but if you don't have any arguments in a relationship, then something might probably be wrong as well. Next story was posted by Turbo Veggie. We lived next to this big guy in an apartment building, front doors inside a hallway, and now he was a nice enough guy, but he was always cleaning a puddle up in front of his apartment every other day. We would always ask him if everything was alright and he would talk some incoherent crap about how he hates management. So, out of curiosity, I asked management when I happened to be in the rental office and the lady rolls her eyes and says, "This idiot fills up his tub to the brim and sits his fat ass in the tub. The water of course floods his entire apartment and comes out into the hallway. And this idiot has the balls to blame us somehow." I pretty much said, "Geez, that sounds rough," and scurried on back to my place. If the tub story is really the truth, this guy must be dumb as rocks. And honestly, if someone tells you a ridiculous story like this, then it's most likely true, because who the hell would come up with something like that? Next one was posted by Memento Mori 4. As a follow-up to the post before, this reminds me of my upstairs neighbor. He takes bath constantly and he ended up flooding out bathroom twice before the dumbest event. Water was off in the building because they were fixing the hot water heater. Dude goes to take a bath, no water, so he leaves for work. Without turning the faucet off, so halfway through the day, maintenance turns the water back on, his tub fills up and I hear a waterfall in the bathroom. Water literally raining through the ceiling. It got in the paint and made weird pockets too. Fortunately, the maintenance guys were right outside cleaning up from their work, so they went upstairs and turned the tub off. But holy crap, I'm glad I was home. Next one was posted by Golf and That. When I lived with my parents, we had a knock at the door one day from our neighbors across the road. They told us a story that resulted in their car getting stolen the night before. Apparently, the wife had seen a strange-looking man wandering around the street late at night. He had apparently been looking into car windows which were parked on driveways, including our cars. The next morning, their BMW was gone, including the keys which were hanging by the front door of their house. They assumed the strange man looking in car windows had somehow fished the keys from the house via the letterbox. The whole thing sounded very strange, to not call the police when a man is literally peering through car windows on people's driveways was strange enough. Months later, the neighbors got a divorce and sold their house. Turns out, they had made the whole thing up and had dumped the car for the insurance as they had fallen on hard times. Apparently, their crappy story had not held up well and they were found out. Who broadcasts a story like that? Why make yourself look stupid for not calling the police when seeing a strange man eyeing up cars? Then tell all the neighbors about the man. Yeah, I mean, honestly, if you want to cheat the system, you at least gotta be a little bit smarter than that. Also, interestingly enough, insurance fraud is something I have not heard about in years actually. But I suppose people are still trying it, it just doesn't get reported as much in the media. Posted by anonymous person. A neighbor messed up when building a home and put his entire home well within my property. Large piece of land with two huge clearings connected to two roads but separated by a large isthmus of trees, and what the hell is that word, I've never heard that before, I did not notice because I had taken an 8-month vacation right after he started building. Huge property, I did not go around and inspect it often. So I got a real estate lawyer and surveyors to confirm it was in my property. I was going to sell him that clearing for a good price until I went to talk to him, and he was the biggest shit I had ever met. He essentially told me that he's going to sue me for leading him on, despite the fact that I did not know him, nor have did I met him before that day. His wife flipped my girlfriend and I as we were pulling out of their driveway. 4 months later, I file a lawsuit saying he must destroy the property or turn it over to me immediately. It would have cost him more to demolish it and return the site to original condition, so he signed the house over to me. He was still out for construction costs. I was living in a single wide with my girlfriend, and I had brand new 2,600 square feet house with all the hookups for water, electricity and cable for free. Got the land for next to nothing, sold it for almost 50 times the value. And that last story is almost as good as winning the lottery. Damn. Are you guys fortunate enough to have inherited a piece of land or something? Near where I live in Germany, there are a lot of farmers who got land from like, I don't know, maybe 100 years ago, and they are basically sitting on millions upon millions of euros in case they would sell the land. But anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed the stories for today. The topic is still neighbors from hell, so to say, but obviously this was an Ask Reddit thread, so if you like this format, which consists of many shorter stories, then please tell me in the comments. I hope you have a fantastic day and I see you again tomorrow.